Kunga. Five letters, two syllables. Simple? Growing up in the Himalayas, in Sikkim, my birthplace, Kunga was the most common name in the state. Go to the top of the mountain and throw a rock, and best believe it will hit a Kunga. But this wasn't the case when I came to the United States for education. I arrived to the United States on August 13, 2011, and every single time I introduced myself, I received confused faces and stutters in trying to pronounce my name right. And also some light jokes about how it sounds very African. So, rewinding back to why I decided to come to the United States. Well, my dad is a stern, content Buddhist who lives by the values of simplicity and humility, and has always taught my sisters and I to be compassionate, modest, and have respect for all sentient beings. My mother, on the other hand, is an independent, self-built, career-oriented woman who is a living example for women empowerment, especially in a male-dominated society like India, where my sisters and I were looked down for simply being girls, and looked as nothing but burdens to our parents. So I came to America to fight this male patriarchy, which at the time I thought would be achieved if I became a doctor in America, one of the most prestigious professions in the world, right? But I wasn't prepared for all the culture shocks and all the unwanted surprises that welcomed me with every breath my Sikkimese self took in this American land. I was different, and that made me very uncomfortable.
I was so uncomfortable being different that I wanted to be a part of the crowd, the culture, so bad. Because from the type of food I had to eat to the type of conversations I was required to have, every little thing challenged my father's values.
But at the same time, I was mesmerized by all the freedom that I had in hand. I didn't have a 5 p.m. curfew anymore. I didn't have to finish every single grain of rice from my plate anymore. And most importantly, I didn't have to fear crushing my voice anymore. Fun. I was slowly immersing myself into this American life. Now, I'm not implying that American life is bad, but it was bad for me because I was starting to look down on things that made me different, which were things that made me Sikkimese. But who was I fooling? I am Sikkimese. It says it on my name, my accent, and my face. I could try till my hair falls out, but I'd never be able to abandon something that is a part of me, my identity. But this fight against my identity wasn't just simply rooted within me. It was more so because of the environment that surrounded me. Oftentimes, as American students, we have no mean intentions, of course, but tend to have preconceived notions about international students. So they look at us and treat us differently. So then there is this lack in understanding that shapes our differences to be perceived as bad or inferior, which is completely untrue. Every culture is special and different, yet important. So a culture bridge between international students and American students is extremely important in building a diversified yet healthily cultured college environment where each and every one of us feels safe and accepted. By this, I mean that it takes personal initiative from both the international students and American students in understanding that differences among us aren't bad at all. It actually helps foster opportunities that we might be completely unaware of otherwise. So to all the American students, go attend an international club meeting or an international festival. To all the international students, don't be afraid if your English isn't fluent. Remind yourself that you probably speak more languages than anybody in the room, so your non-fluency in English doesn't make you any less competent. Well, talking about competency, there's this term called cultural competency, right? Well, I'm not a very big fan of the term competency because it's humanly impossible to be competent in the 100 million cultures around the world. Which is why I like to use this term called cultural humility. Cultural humility is a perception that allows us to be humble, sensitive, and respectful of cultures other than our own. It's not tough being humble and respectful, right? So it helps in relationship building without having to know everything about the culture. This perception of cultural humility has helped me get to where I am now. I've applied that in every single step that I've been here in America. And you all should give it a thought too. Because nothing really has changed for me. People still give me confused faces when I introduce myself and still ask me to spell my name. But it doesn't bother me anymore. Now I love being different. because I know that I always have something to offer to the room. And to all the international students out there, you do too. Today, I share the stage with my friend Yves, who comes from a completely different culture and has a completely different experience than mine. But the one thing that we have in common is that we both are trying to secure our future beyond our cultural borders. Thank you.
Thank you, Yves. So, what do you think when you hear my accent? He's not from America. He's a foreigner. He probably doesn't speak or write English well. He speaks other languages. I am from Rwanda. Rwanda is a very beautiful country. We call it a country of a thousand hills. We have a saying in my language that goes like this. God roams around the world and comes back to bed in Rwanda. So as a young kid, I enjoyed the smell of the air. I enjoyed playing with other kids. I enjoyed listening to other folks and telling me about stories about my culture and the history. However, growing up in this beautiful country, I knew little about the history that my country had faced, a very tragic history. In 1994, Rwanda experienced a genocide. A genocide that claimed almost a million people. This was a very tragic time for both Rwanda, Africa, and the world. However, through this tragic time, Rwanda has managed to heal, rebuild, and be one of the growing economies in sub-Saharan Africa. Now my story starts with my mom. My mom was able to escape the genocide, and I was born in a refugee camp in Congo. So through my mom's work, I got to go back and visit the refugee camp. It is really a hopeless place, a place with people who have no sense of belonging. However, when you meet those people, you have this hope that one day, or the next day, or tomorrow, they'll find a home. There will be some better place for them. And looking at myself being born in a refugee camp, maybe the whole world was going to be a home for me. My future would be built beyond borders. So my earliest memory growing up in Rwanda, my first close friend was American. He taught me my first English words. I taught him some Kinyarwanda, and I taught him how to play soccer. He taught me how to play with Legos. Yes, I knew what Legos were. And this, connecting people from different culture at an early age, different languages barriers, amazed me so much that I wanted to go and learn about other countries and learn about other cultures. And this continued as my family moved to Kenya. So for 5 years, I got to build great friendships and bonds, and I picked up a fourth language, which is Swahili. So as my family moved back to Rwanda, I finished my high school in Uganda. This was one of the best times of my life. I had friends from India, Lebanon, Yemen, Uganda, South Sudan, Somalia. So through connecting these friends of mine, I got to see the world through a different eyes. And this kind of taught me a big lesson that even though these countries had gone through their tragic times, I got to experience and know the humanity, the good, through the eyes of my friends. And so as my passion for learning about other cultures continued, I had this opportunity and I was casted in a feature film called Africa United as one of the leading actors. So Africa United is about a story about five kids who travel from Rwanda to South Africa to watch the World Cup. And this gave me an opportunity to live in South Africa and learn about the culture, learn about their languages. And finally, with all the movie stuff happening, we were able to travel to England and London to do the premiere. And this was my first time out of Africa. And it was a really good experience for me to be first time out of Africa, learn about all these people, and experience new culture. And this further opened doors to come here to the United States to get an education. It was a very nervous and exciting time. I was interested in immersing in a new space to learn about different people who come here to get an education and see how that goes for me. So in the US, it's very hard to adapt. It is very hard to learn to listen to the southern drawl. It is very hard to, find new people who have different languages, express joy differently, express happiness differently, and to learn how to, to be receptive to those things. However, through this experience, I've learned to be a better citizen of the world and be a better human being. So America is securing our future by welcoming me as a young African man and to bring all my stories and influence into this education. And this great education has helped me be a better person. Even though it's hard sometimes, like I remember my first paper, I didn't know what fonts to use, how to cite things. I remember my first programming class. It was very hard to kind of follow all these rules to build an application. However, deep within me, I knew that this was the skills that were going to create a borderless world. And it went further when, as a drummer, I took a jazz history class, a music that has deep roots within Africa, but has grown to become a borderless sound with different cultural influences. So our future beyond borders is the only future. When we welcome other people from other backgrounds and trust each other, we create a better future for everybody. So I would have never imagined I'd be standing here talking to people about how my interactions with different people from different cultures has shaped my view of the world. And when we remain open to see other people from their experiences, we come together, build a future beyond boundaries. Thank you very much for listening to us.